Hello everyone, and welcome to our webinar on the use of a ServiceNow as a incident management tool. My name is Vishal Jaiswar, and I am going to deliver this webinar. And we are thrilled to have you join us today. So before we start the webinar, just a little bit introduction about myself. I am Vishal Jaiswar, working as a corporate trainer in Koenig Solution. I have expertise in delivering training for ServiceNow platforms. And within the ServiceNow platforms, I have expertise as a ITSM fundamental. I have expertise as a discovery user. Also, I have expertise as a CMDB specialist. And to say about my certifications, I am a certified system administrator, also a certified implementation specialist in IT service management, as well as in the discovery. Along with this, I hold expertise in web technologies, programming languages, and software development. So what this webinar is about? So this webinar is basically focused on how we can utilize the ServiceNow platform specialty for the incident management. Okay. And this basically includes the following topics, such as the overview of incident management, ServiceNow features, and the workflows and process automations, and then the best practices. Yeah, and these are the agendas that we are going to discuss today. And this agenda basically provide a structured outline for covering essential topics related to the ServiceNow as a ITSM tool, as a IT service management tool. In short, we call them as a ITSM tool. And I believe in the webinar, we have a mix of people, some of with the experience in the ServiceNow, and some of them are very new to the ServiceNow. So we will start with the basic one, like about what is ServiceNow. Okay, so we'll start with the overview of ServiceNow. Then we will understand what is incident management, and then what are the key features of incident management. Okay, we will see all those things. And this webinar is 1 hour for sure, and we'll cover the above agendas, and also we have a dedicated question and answer session towards the end, where you can submit your questions, and I'll look into it, and I'll try to answer those questions at the end. Okay, you can give me a thumbs up for the confirmation. So whatever questions you have related to the webinar, you can just paste your queries in the Teams, and I'll look into it at the end. Okay, so guys, let's start our training. So let's start with the overview of a ServiceNow. So what is a ServiceNow? So ServiceNow is a cloud-based IT management tool, which is used to automate the business processes and provides the best services to the customers and encourage best practices in managing all the services as a business. When I'm saying that ServiceNow is a cloud-based IT management tool, it means, let's take one example, okay? You open any browser and you connect your browser with internet, okay? And you go to the application that you are never gonna install on your system. Let's say Instagram. You go to the Instagram. You just log in through the on the internet, and you use the services of Instagram without installing that application on your system. So that is a cloud-based application. Okay. So in like that, ServiceNow is also a cloud-based application and automation tool. When I'm saying the automation tool, that means it automates your daily tasks, it automates your repeated tasks with the help of a ServiceNow. Okay, that is the automated task. And we have the below are the key benefits of ServiceNow, and those benefits are integration capabilities, scalability, and automation of a routine task. When I'm saying the integration capabilities, that means you can integrate this ServiceNow with the different in the different modules of a ServiceNow. You can integrate ServiceNow with the CMDB. You can integrate this ServiceNow with the problem management, change management, all those things. Okay. But once again, this ServiceNow was first introduced as a ITSM tool. It introduced as a IT service management tool. Okay. And it includes the various IT activities such as incident management, problem management, change management, asset management, knowledge management. Okay. So in the starting, they used to provide their services in the ITSM area only. But now they are becoming very huge, and now they are providing services in cloud-based area as well. When I'm saying they used to provide their services in the ITSM, that means, let's take one example. You just joined in your company and you are not able to send any mail on Outlook. Okay. So in that case, what you will do, you'll just raise an incident that I'm not able to send any messages on Outlook. Okay. So if your company subscribes to the ServiceNow ITSM, then the ServiceNow ITSM team will provide you the solution. Like they will provide you the structure that how you can raise the incident and till how you can resolve those incidents, how those ServiceNow team will resolve those incidents for you. So those things they used to provide in their initial days in the IT service management tool. So in this webinar, we will only focus on the IT service management tool of a service. If you have any questions, you can just type in the chat. I'll answer at the end. I'll answer them today. Then let's move to the next slide, which is introduction to incident management. What is incident management? So incident management is a process to manage IT service disruptions and restore service within the service levels. Okay. So as I told you that incident management is a process to manage IT service disruptions. In the previous example, we have seen that like if our Outlook is not working, so it's like a IT service disruptions. So this incident management is capable of solving those type of a problem. So this incident management in ServiceNow refers to the process of managing the life cycle of incident to ensure that the service operation and restore as quickly as possible. Okay. So with the help of this, we can minimize the impact on the business operation. Just take the example of Outlook. Okay. If you resolve that issue on the given time, that means it will impact on your businesses. Okay. It will give you a positive impact on your businesses. So incident management is very crucial for your businesses. That is the introduction to incident. Then in the next slide, we have the key features of ServiceNow incident management. Like what features are included in this incident management. So below are the features. So here, it starts with the main feature is incident logging. Okay. So what is incident logging? So in this feature, ServiceNow ITSM, they provides you easy and multiple channels so that you can report your incidents. For example, you can report your incident by yourself. Like they will provide you some modules called self-services. From there, you can report, you can create your own incidents. And you can also create an incident from the calls, from the chats, from the emails, or also from the automated alerts. Okay. These are some ways to creating an incident in ServiceNow. The next we have is categorization and prioritization. So what that means? So that means incidents are categorized based on the predefined criteria. Okay. That means let's suppose the Outlook issue is related to the software. Okay. So it will categorize under the software. And software team will look into that issue. So it automatically assigns that incident to software team. That is a categorization. And then the prioritization. Prioritization means provide the, let's suppose that incident is very crucial, okay? And the priority is high for that particular incident. So that means you have to complete, you have to provide solution as soon as possible for that particular incident. So that is the prioritization. Then assigning and routing. So what is assigning and routing? So assigning basically automated assign the incidents, okay, to the appropriate groups based on the category and the subcategory. Okay, in most of the cases, you just you need to fill the details. I'll tell you what kind of details you need to fill. So based on that details, it will automatically assign that incident to particular group. Okay, and you also can assign that particular incident to the group. So it depends upon you. Then we have a workflow and the work automation. So then we have a workflow and the automation. So what is workflow and the automation? So it basically customize that how your incident flow look like from logging to the resolution states. All those things you can customize on that workflow. Then we have a knowledge management integration. That means for that particular incident in our system, we have some knowledge articles. Let's suppose if the same type of an incident occurs, so there should be some kind of articles. So next time, if suppose the same issue is occurs, so you can share that particular article to that incident. So that is the knowledge management integration. Again, the same communication and the collaboration is basically you can communicate with your team for that particular incident. Okay, so via work notes and additional comments from these two areas, you can communicate with your teams. Then we have incident resolution and the closure. So this one is again a key feature of IT service management tool. Okay, where you can provide after providing a workaround, you can just close the incidents based on that workaround. So that is the key feature of a ServiceNow for incident management. So till now, whatever we have seen in the incident management, we will perform a one demo for that. Okay, so for that I have a scenario as well for this. So let's check that scenario. Okay, so the scenario is saying that, okay, there is a XYZ organization that hosted an annual conference, okay, and they use a mobile application to facilitate event management. Okay, and during the contact conference, a staff encounter an issue where the application crashes while accessing the scheduled feature. Okay, so while accessing the scheduled feature, the application got crashed. So the organization uses a ServiceNow as their incident management to handle this situation. Okay, so we are going to handle this incident, which is the mobile application get crashes during the mobile conference. Okay, so what we will do? So as a end user, there is a one person. Okay, for example, there is a pet Anglin. She is a user. So she will create an incident. Okay, so basically, pet Anglin, let's suppose she is an administrator of a service now, and a Freight Ludi is the end user. Okay, so Freight Ludi will raise this incident that I am not able to use this application because of the crashes while scheduling the feature. Okay, that is our scenario. So let's perform this scenario. Okay, so now I will take you to the platform of a service now. I hope my screen is visible to everyone. So right now we are in the ServiceNow platform. Okay, this is my personal developer instance, which is a free of a cost. Okay, so from here we will in this platform we will perform our IT as a scenario, IT service management scenario. So before we start our practical demonstration, let me just explain what are these spaces, what are these interfaces on this particular platform. So can you see this grid line at the top where we have all favorites, history, workspaces? We call them as a banner. Okay, in the banner we have all. So all from here you can navigate to different applications. So this is the filter application navigator. When I'm saying the application, so let's suppose here, let's type incident first. Can you see this here? We have incident, and when I expand this incident, we have create new, assign to me, open. So here, incident is a application. In ServiceNow, they called it as a applications and the modules. So create new, assign to me, open. All these are modules, and incident is a application, because under this incident we have all this. So that is the application navigator. Then we have a favorites. So whatever application or the modules you are going to use frequently, you can make them as a favorite. Okay, for example, suppose I'm making this create new as a favorite. So now it will come under the favorite. Yeah. Then we have a history, like the most recent searches you can find under the history. Then we have a workspaces. Workspace is basically just a, you can say, the modern experience. Okay, I'll tell you what is modern view and model experience. Okay, as compared to the normal one, we'll see those things later. Then here we have a search. So this one is a global search. From here you can search any incident number, any problem, any change. So this is a single place from where you can search. You can navigate to any incident number, problem number, or change number. Then here we have the avatar for the users. So currently we have logged in as a system administrator. Okay, so this is the system administrator profile. He is an admin of this platform. In this we have a different profiles. So we have a different profiles. So currently we have logged in as a system administrator. So here in the profile, basically the details of us, that particular user will show under here. So that let's check that. Like the first name, last name, all email, all those information will be available here. Okay. Now we have an impersonate user. Okay. This is very important topic in ServiceNow, important concept you can say. When I'm saying the impersonate user, that means you can as an admin, as a ServiceNow administrator, you can impersonate to anyone. Okay, that means you can go to someone else's shoes for checking if whatever the changes you have made, if it is working fine or not. Okay. Let's take a one hypothetical situation. System administrator created some modules and he have created some work. Now he wants to test that particular changes is reflecting to that user or not. So what he will do, he will just impersonate to a user. Let's suppose he impersonate something. Let's say he's impersonate to this let's say Alessandro Mescal. Okay, if let's say he impersonate her, so impersonate him, sorry. So now he can go to that person instance, and now he can test whether the changes are reflecting or not. So that is the impersonation. Okay, we will also use this impersonation in our lab demonstration. Okay, so now I'm just clicking on end impersonation. Now we are going back as a system, ServiceNow system administrator. Again, so yeah, this one is user interface. From here, we can create applications in ServiceNow. Okay, application like this. the employee centered knowledge, all kind of approach. That is the platform overview. Now, let's perform our scenario. Let me show you that scenario once again. So this is our scenario, okay, where the scenario is saying that during the conference, a staff, basically a user, they have encountered an issue where the application crashes when they're accessing the scheduled features, okay? So we need to provide a solution for that particular incident. So we will create an incident first. Okay, so let's go back to the application. So scenario here is that let's suppose the user is Fred Ludi, okay, and the Fred Ludi called to the Beth Anglin. Beth Anglin is a ITSM administrator, let's suppose. She is working into the service now. So Fred Ludi, a user, Beth Anglin is an administrator. Okay, this clear this persona. So Fred Ludi called to the Beth Anglin that, hey Beth, I'm facing this this issue. So let's impersonate Beth. That means we will go to the Beth Anglin shoes. Okay, let me search. Okay, Beth Anglin. So we will create an incident from here. Go back to the incident. Create new. Okay. Yeah, so let's create an incident. So here the caller is Fred Ludi. And Fred Ludi is saying that, okay, let's mention short description. So basically, this is the form. This is the incident form. You have to fill all the mandatory fields in this. And after filling this form, then it will create an incident for you. It will create an incident from your from your issue. So the short description is like the issue this Fred Ludi is facing. Mobile application crashes when accessing the schedule feature. Okay, we have seen the same scenario. We have seen the same issue in the scenario. So let's create a short description for this. Mobile application crashes. Yeah. So to creating any incidents, you have to fill the form. So this one is the basic form. And here we have, so as you can see, this asterisk mark, that means they are mandatory. You need to fill these fields in the incident form. Okay. So let's say the short description is mobile application crashes when accessing the schedule feature. This is the short schedule feature, okay? And Fred Ludi. So right now, this Beth Anglin is creating an incident for her, for Fred Ludi. But how she know that this Fred Ludi is facing this issue? So Fred Ludi basically calls to the Beth Anglin, okay? So via phone call, they have discussed this. Okay, I am facing this issue. Please create an incident for me. So via phone call, so let me put the channel 4. So via phone call, she informed her about the issue. Okay, so we have to choose the short description according to that. Okay, and now she's also and the Beth, the Fred Ludi informed that this one is very priority one. Okay, so we need to solve this on urgent basis. So we'll the impact will be high. Urgency also will be high. So priority automatically calculated as a critical. Okay, based on these two, it's automatically get calculated. So now we'll select the category. So we know that it is related to the software, right? mobile application crashes. So it's related to the software. Okay. Now we will we'll choose some configuration item. Okay. What is CI? Configuration item which on that particular device it affected. So that is a CI, configuration item. So let's select the device. Let's search the mobile mobile. Okay. So I'm selecting this mobile phone tool. So that means on that mobile phone tool, this incident, the scenario, the, this incident is like they affected on that particular device, which is a mobile phone. Now select the services. Let's check if we have, yeah, let's select the IT services. It is related to the IT services. So we'll choose IT services. Okay. Yes. So we have provided all the mandatory details. Also, we have provided services, categories, and the configuration item. We will also provide assignment group for this particular incident. Let's suppose, let's assign this to the software group. Let's check if we have any software group or not. Yeah, we have a software. So we'll assign this particular incident to the software team. Okay. And right now, I'm not assigning this incident to anyone. Okay. Beth Anglin, she's a admin. She's an administrator. So, she has the power to assign this incident to anyone. But right now, we are not going to assign an incident. So, yeah. After this, you can. I think we have some other things. Work notes. Yes. Can you see? There is a work notes and the additional comment section. So what are these? So work notes basically where you can write the informations like that can communicate with your team. Okay. So whatever you need to like whatever let's suppose you have some information and you want to share with your team. So those things you can just provide under the work notes and your team members can see can check those information those notes while solving that particular incident. And you know, an additional comment is basically for the end users, like whoever are raising the incidents. Okay, they can see that okay, what is the progress of my incident at where they have solved those incidents. So those things will cover under the additional information. So let's say hey Fred, we are working on this. And in work notes, let's say please start working on this, okay? So we have created this, okay? So now I'm going to submit this. I'm going to submit this incident form. Okay, so let's say let me save the incident form first. Then we'll submit this. Okay, so see once you save the form in the related list, you can see there is the different activities. For example, whatever. See the bet and whatever information filled by the bet, it's showing again here. Then the work notes as well as the additional comment is also showing up over here. Okay. And below we have some affected CI. That means on that particular device, we are facing an issue that whatever the incidents we have created, like whatever the issue we have, mobile application crashes. So that is happening on this particular CI on particular device, which is a mobile phone tool. Okay. Then there is a task SLA. That means as this one is a priority one, okay? Priority one is critical. So that means you have to provide a solution within the 1 hour. Okay? But in the real world scenario, it's not like they will not give you like the 1 hour. Okay, they will provide you the two to three days of a timing to resolve the priority one. But in some cases, you might need to provide a solution in 12 hours. Okay, that is case. So here we have created an incident. So this is the incident number, okay? Again, I'm just copying this incident number. Okay. So again, let me go back to the all so that I can show you that what is the classic view and what is the modernized view. Yeah. So let me refresh thing. Yeah. So yeah. So this incident which we have created earlier, right, like in the previous day, which is mobile application crashes when accessing the schedule feature. Okay. So this is the a normal, we can say not a normal normal way. So this is the I forget that name. Yeah. So this is the classical way to creating an incident. So from, and this is the list view. From, you can see the numbers, open, short description, all these columns, and you can read your information. Okay. So this is the classic view of creating incidents and handling those incidents. So we have created an incident and the state is in new. That means this incident is, we have created this incident, but again, we need to solve this incident. Okay. So now let's jump into the modern view and we will work on the same particular, on the same incident. Okay. So to go to the modern view, there is a workspace and there is a service operation workspace. So click over there. Okay. So yeah, I told you that with the, like we will see workspace later. So yeah. So workspace is basically is a more more modern experience, or the more they will provide you the more widgets into that. Okay, let me take you. Let me tell you. So I'm just typing the incident which we have created up below in the previous step. Okay. So can you see? As I told you that this one is a modern modern experience. That means it will provide the more graphical representations. Okay, the same incident. So the same incident you have this seen in that, in the classical view, that there is just a list view and just a normal plain structure. But here, see, we have a detail. So not a detail. We have some eye-catching overview, some eye-catching interfaces. For example, let's say in the detail, we have the same information, we have same incident, that incident number 1004, column is same, all the things are the same, all the information are same. But again, this one is they have provided in the more graphical representations. Okay, so we will work it from here. See, in the middle pane, we have the activity pane, comment, work notes, all those things. Okay, so you can create your incident from modern experience or from the normal experience. It will both are the same. And you can also edit the details from here as well. So let's suppose if I want to change that channel, so you can easily change that channel. Okay, but right now I'm not going to change any channel. Okay, so Beth Anglin, basically what she going to do, she going to assign this incident to herself only. Okay. So just, I know one more thing, just focus on this activity section. Okay. We have seen all these things under the related list of that incident form, where we have seen all the things, but here they are providing in such a, eye-catching interface. So what I'll do, I'll assign this incident to, this Beth Anglin. Right now we have logged as a Beth Anglin. Okay, so Beth Anglin will assign this incident to herself only. When I'm clicking to assign to me, it will automatically assign to her. So see, now right now it is assigned to the Beth Anglin, but it, previously it was on a new. Okay, that means in a progress. So but now it is assigned to herself. Okay, so what we can do next? So here on your right hand side, we have these options like recommended action. Then we have agent assist. So let's click on that. Let's see what we have it. Yeah. So basically, it's kind of a knowledge management, okay, where we have some type of articles that might related to your issue. Okay, so what Beth Anglin is going to do, So Beth Anglin review the incident, and she thinks that let's suppose this Eclipse configuration for Android. Okay, this particular article, I'm just taking a scenario. I'm not sure whether this article is going to help her or not, but just assume this particular article is going like based on that particular incident. This article is perfect. Like this article can resolve Fred Ludi's incident. So she will do one thing. She will just attach it. Okay, she will attach, and in the comment she will write, "Hey Fred, please follow the instructions mentioned in the article and let me know if your issue resolved or not." Okay. And I'm going to attach this particular article. So it will update this information. See here in the activity saying that Beth Anglin attached some type of article. So just imagine the scenario in your mind. Okay. So Fred raised the incident and raised the incident, and Beth Anglin worked on that particular incident, and she provided some type of a knowledge management, some type of articles that contain the solution for that particular issue. Okay. So now what she will do, under over we have some resolutions. Okay, so she will add a resolution node. Resolution code would like workaround provided. Okay, let's suppose that. Okay, so we have provided a workaround. Okay, now what we will do, we will click on resolve. So this incident is resolved. Okay, that means as a administrator, I have provided a solution to the user. Okay, so I'm just making as a resolve. So now the state of this incident is in resolve, but you cannot close this incident from your end until you didn't receive any response from the client. Okay, so you cannot close this incident. So now Fred will check, okay, whatever the articles Beth Anglin shared with me, if that article is right, like if that article is helpful or not. So she will check. If it is helpful for her, then she will close this incident. Okay. So now what we can do, we'll go to the Fred Ludi's instance. Okay. So Fred Ludi is a, we can say, end user, the user like us, you and me. Okay. So we'll go to the Fred Ludi's instance. We'll impersonate, click on impersonate user. So right now we are in the Fred Ludi's instance. Okay. So here, look at that name. One second. So to view the incident which created by ourselves, like so there is a one portal. There's a portal name is employee center. Okay, from here you can see what incidents the status of your incident. Okay, that is, you can check all those things under the employee center portal. Employee center. Okay, so under sales service, we have a employee center. Okay, so this sales service application is available for all the users. So at let's suppose if we have a ITIL user. Okay, the ITIL user is a very basic role which provided to the provided to the user. So if you have that particular role, you can create an incident as well. Okay, but here this Fred didn't create an incident. Instead of this, he called the Beth and she created from there. But again, you can create your incident from your own, from this particular portion, portal. So let's go to the employee center. Click taking some time. Yeah, so here under my task, no, because you haven't created anything, okay? So under my request, because it is in request, see, mobile application crashes, okay? The request which raised by you, now the status in resolved, okay? And updated 3 minutes ago. So let's open that particular incident, particular request. So see, in the activity, you can see all the things like the article which shared by the Beth Anglin is also there. So let's open that article first and let's check. So see, the Fred Ludi will basically open that article and she will check if that whatever the steps they have mentioned, if the steps are useful or not. Okay. So let's suppose while following this step, the issue has been solved. So what she will do, she will just let's suppose, yeah, this article is helpful for me. Okay. And let's click on helpful article, let's suppose, and click on comment. Okay, so now go back. So that means this article is helpful for you. So now you can close your incident. That okay, I am going to close this incident because my issue has been resolved. So what I'll do as a Beth Anglin, I'll click on action and I'll click on this close. Before closing, let me copy this incident account. Let's close this. Yeah. Can you see we have got the message that your incident has been permanently closed. So let's check that if this one closed or not. Okay. So let's click on end impersonation. Okay. So we'll check, we'll go as an administrator. Okay. And we'll check here. You can see all your incidents. So I'll search incident under all. Okay. Can you see our incident number 1000004? The priority, the status is closed. That means the workaround which provided by the Beth Anglin is useful for the Fred Ludi, and she closed the particular incident. So let's open that particular. So it's closed one. Okay. So in this way, in the real world scenario, you can raise an incident and your admin team will look into it and they will provide you the solution. So like if you are planning to work as an administrator, then you have to you need to work like this. You need to provide the workarounds to the particular issue. You need to provide articles. You need to manage those things. Okay, you need to provide this all this information. So that's how ITSM works under the service managed under the ServiceNow. I believe we have completed our practical demonstration for this, for the incident management in ServiceNow. We have completed our practical demonstration. Now again, go back to the slides and let's check once again. Okay, so that was the flow. First, we have logged in as an administrator, and then we have created an incident which we got. We have created an incident which we have received from the Fred Ludi, and then we have filled the basic information on that particular form. After that, we have provided a workaround. Then we have submitted our points onto that particular form, and then the user at the end, once he or she finds that the particular workaround is perfect, then she just close the particular incident. So in this way, you can manage an incident in ServiceNow, in IT service management. So right now we are in the questions and the query. So now what I'll do, I'll look the questions and which you have asked for me. Okay. Yes, definitely it's look like a Salesforce, because all these are the ITL, IT service management tools. So this ServiceNow, Salesforce, Manage Engine, all they work on the same infrastructure. Basically, on the motto is also same. But again, this ServiceNow is different from all those two other applications, because ServiceNow basically follows the multi-level architecture. Okay, so that means they will provide you the multiple instance, so you can manage your work. But again, in other application, they will provide you the single level of architect. So anything goes wrong to that particular instance, so it will affect to your work. So that is the difference between the Salesforce Manage Engine and the ServiceNow. Yeah. So you asked me that how can we build or install this to monitor our network? Okay. You mean you're asking that how we can go to the ServiceNow personal developer instance? So for that, okay. Just simply search the ServiceNow. ServiceNow developer instance. Okay. From this page, just go to the ServiceNow developer. Let me share the link with you guys. Okay, copy. So from here, you can create your account. Okay. Let me just sign out. So from here, you can sign up and you can create your account. And after creating account, just sign in. Okay. So after sign in, they will provide you the instance. So from there, you can just go back and you can log into that particular page. So Kate Thomas, you asked me that, is there any open source for this App Engine Studio? So you can, basically this App Engine Studio is for creating, developing applications and the modules under the ServiceNow. So yes, but again, this one is a free instance. Okay. So on this particular, instance, you can provide, you can work very limited things. Okay. If you want to work on, this App Engine Studio, then, you need to buy plugins. You need to buy application development plugin. Okay. All that, for that also, we can provide you, like our company will provide you that instance as well. Then Ravindra asked, like, what is the cost to implement in organization? Can it be integrated with SAP applications to automate the ticketing? Okay. I'm not sure about the cost, but yes, you can integrate ServiceNow with SAP applications. Like I have already worked on this. I have integrated the ServiceNow with the Jira and forget that name. Jira and to the GitHub, where we can automatically create an incident on the Jira application. Okay, so yes, you can integrate with the SAP, but I'm not sure about the cost. Yes, Bridges, you can create a free account. So currently I am using the free version, okay, free instance of a ServiceNow. So just create your account and you will it will direct you to this instance. It will automatically direct to this instance, which on this page, okay, on this one. So yes, you can create a free account for practice, but again, they will provide you the limited options in this. Okay, so you can perform very limited option on you can perform very limited options on this. Yes.